Hello, 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 and welcome to Peppy Pronunciation 3. My name is Steve Ford, and you have come to PrivateEnglishPortal.com. After many requests from many of my students, I would today like to talk about word stress.
Your tongue. Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Frustrating.
Frustrating.
Advertisement.
Advertisement.
U.S.
U.K.
U.S.
U.K.
Correct. Teenager.
Teenager.
Correct.
Interesting.
Interesting.
Translate.
Translate. Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue?
Too often in my experience teaching accent reduction, I come across students from all over the world who need to work on their word stress. So I would like to lay a lot of your doubts to rest today. I have studied many other languages, and what I have noticed is that scholars of those languages went to a lot of trouble to make sure that the word stress and pronunciation was carefully mapped out so that there was no doubt whatsoever about how to pronounce those languages. Unfortunately, somewhere along the way, English did not do that. And this is what creates a lot of confusion for a lot of people learning English. Of course, we do have phonetic alphabets, and for people who have time and patience to learn them, they can be quite handy. But what happened with all of those accent marks that we can find in so many other languages? Where is the GPS device? Are you lost with your word stress in English? Well, I don't blame you, and you're not alone. Sometimes we can have a variety of pronunciation and word stress just to make things more complicated for you, and I hope to clear those up with you today. First of all, I would like to start off with interesting or interesting. Right there, you can hear a difference between interesting and interesting. My students will come to me and ask me which one is correct. In fact, both are correct, and it's a question of your own preference. There are many adjectives like that. You can say adult, or you could say adult. These are all very subtle. In most situations, native speakers understand if you use either. Now, in some cases, we come across abbreviations, such as US or UK, and you can notice that we're using the word stress on the second letter. Now, if you take a word stress pronunciation error and put that together with a few more problems with pronunciation of open and closed vowel sounds, this is what might make it difficult for a native speaker to understand you. And we can correct those, of course. Once again, we just need to start to categorize your mistakes. And as soon as we can do that, you can start to do self-correction and feel better about your English. If your language has a cognate, has a similar word, it becomes a little bit more difficult. So if you take my first example, interesting or interesting, in other languages which have a similar word, quite often, the word stress will fall on the last syllable or at the end of the word. If you do not have a cognate, a similar word in your language, lucky you, you can memorize this a lot quicker. So it's really important for you to practice, and pay attention to how native speakers are using word stress for those longer words in English. Some other examples along those lines are longer ones like fascinating. problematic, and even longer, anti-constitutionally. Anti-constitutionally. So as the words get longer and longer, the word stress tends to vary. So you really want to pay attention. Write down that part of the word where the word stress falls. You can see that I use that strategy when I am making my videos, and I hope that I can pass that notation on to you. Now that we've talked about some three-syllable words and four-syllable words, I would like to talk about compound nouns. This one comes up a lot during my one-to-one classes. And it is very subtle, but at the same time, it sets apart the person who is a native speaker and somebody who is speaking English as a second language. My first example is high school. The word stress comes on high. Teenager. Once again, the word stress comes on teen. And supermarket. Word stress comes on super. Confusion can arise when you start to use the wrong word stress with numbers in the teens. 13, 14, 15. So you can see that the word stress falls on the second part, but be careful if you're talking about the ertes. 30, 40, 50. It's coming at the beginning so that there is no confusion. My fourth one has to do with word stress on different parts of the same word, which will change its meaning. Some good examples are record and record. So you can see that depending on the context of the sentence, you need to either use a noun or a verb. I'm going to record a record. Well, we don't make records anymore. But it's a good example. Yes, I'm going to record a record. Other examples, object and to object. Progress or to progress. My last point has to do with word stress, which changes from British to American English. Because of British history, there was a proximity with the French language. So the French pronunciation rubbed off on the English pronunciation. With the colonizing of the Americas, that pronunciation started to move away from that initial pronunciation, which was influenced from the French pronunciation. So I'm going to give you some concrete examples. In the UK, they would say frustrating. And in the US, they would say frustrating. In the UK, they would say laboratory. In the US, they would say laboratory. In the UK, they would say aluminium. And in the US, they would say aluminum. Another example is advertisement, which you will find in some regions of the United States and Canada, and advertisement. Lastly, address and address. Castrate. Ooh, castrate. So I will try to make something for you now to try to retain all of this word stress knowledge. I know that it can seem like a labyrinth when you're going through all of this, as I said, because you do not have a GPS device. But hopefully, this will help you to become aware and to classify your own pronunciation mistakes, correct them, and feel more self-confident with your speaking in English. So, we'll see you in Peppy Pronunciation 4. Bye-bye.
Tongue. Your tongue. Tongue. Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Frustrating. Frustrating. Advertisement. Advertisement. U.S. U.K. U.S. U.K. Correct. Teenager. Teenager. Correct. Interesting. Interesting. Translate. Translate. Wesley. Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue? Have you ever had a word on the tip of your tongue?